One of the things that I would like to comment about as part of this discussion, right, and we are essentially talking about how easy or how difficult it is to move from legacy systems, you know, we call it journey to cloud, right, in so many ways, or, you know, embracing analytics, digital, to this move, right, and in terms of strategic advantage, although there are massive strategic advantages in, let's say, for example, moving to the cloud, right? But younger the organization, the faster and the better it is, right? Older the organization, I come from the business side, and you know, there's a lot of vested interests which need to be managed, you know, while moving some of these changes, right? While making some of these changes, I beg your pardon. So obviously, you know, this journey, this is not exactly a move, this is a journey. And it is a well thought out journey. To, most importantly, whenever a decision or a discussion for a journey to cloud analytics or into a digital mindset happens, first thing is to get the strategy of going about it right. I'm very glad that Great Lakes is putting a finger on some of these important topics and giving exposure to the students on how the industry is moving in that direction.
One should, one of the risks I would see is that one has to avoid this indulgence of trying to apply it wherever, that man with the hammer syndrome. So certain businesses are not suited for mobile, let's say. Buying a house is a once in a lifetime activity, you don't need an app for that. Similarly, in certain businesses, data is very difficult to get. Unless you have data, you don't get into analytics. First build the data foundation. So it's more specific. I don't have a very good answer to it. But what I'm saying is one needs to understand what their business is and which of these components and at what stage of their business can be applied.
The key hindrances in terms of large businesses are apprehensions about what will happen to their systems, about losing control on what, on the IT infrastructure, as well as something hidden which they are still not able to apprehend, because the cloud is definitely picking up fast, but people feel that what will happen, what will happen. That's the main issue which is there with the large enterprises. The key business drivers which the people have to move, because there is no looking back. It's there is too much of data available in the social and mobility space, and businesses are not being run in the traditional manner, and but through analytics, through sentimental analytics, through performance behaviors, through risk analytics, which is a output of the on-premise traditional infrastructure, as well as the data or the behavior patterns which are being generated on the social media platforms, the messenger platforms, the emails, and your buying patterns. So if the larger organizations have to sustain themselves, sustain their growth, be innovative, be differentiative, and with the agility and scale with which the new organizations like Airbnbs of the world are doing today, in future they will have to look at a way to shift. Another big resistance which comes from larger IT systems is what will happen to the jobs of the existing IT teams, which are, IT teams are fairly huge, fairly huge, and there is a sense of insecurity among the people themselves of losing their jobs. So that's another reason, but that's not from a perspective of a cloud service provider. We feel there are several more opportunities open, and any transformational, even in the communication industry, which we saw transformation around 2 decades back, we have never seen a differentiation or never seen a job loss happening because of that.